Hello, good day po no. So, welcome po sa ACC 213 and the subject is Strategic Cost Management. So, I am your course facilitator, Jovic G. Cain po. So, we are now in week 6-7 and this is ULO B. So, describe the concept and importance of cost-volume-profit relationship in the operation of the business. So, the first one is yung definition ng CVP. So, if you see CVP analysis, this examines the interaction of a firm's sales volume, so with regard to the volume, the prices, syempre, of the sell, of the selling prices, yes, the cost structure, okay, so yung direct materials, or even you do have here, in this case pala, this is variable cost and fixed cost, and profitability of a particular commodity. Then it is a powerful tool in making managerial decisions including marketing. So how many is yung ibabaligya? Okay, baligya ni company, production, how much is to produce, investment opportunity, it may be kailangan pa ba or there is a need to increase the fixed cost of the company and even financing decisions. So, here are the common reasons that usually managers address. So, how many units of the products must a firm sell to break even? So, if you say break even, which is, yun nga, the profit is zero. So, kumbaga, yung total income is equals to total expenses. So, kanus adi ay, okay, how many units of its product must a firm sell to break even? So, kumbaga, kung sa Bisaya, papila kaya ang ibaligya sa company para makabawi sa iyahang kapital. Okay. And then, how many units of its product must a firm sell to earn a certain amount of profit? So, how many of the units of product naman, okay, para maka-earn na po sa iyahang profit, hindi lang break even. So, the firm invests in highly automated machinery and reduces its labor force. So, is there a need to have or to increase fixed cost ba? Then, should the firm advertise more to improve its sales? So, these are the most common questions that usually managers address. So, again, if it's a CVP analysis, it is the systematic examination of the interrelationship among the revenue, the variable cost, the fixed cost, and activity levels of volume and profit. So, in this case, yun nga, para din sa variable costing. There is a need to separate variable cost at saka yung fixed cost and within the level of activity. Then, CVP permits management to predict the probable effect of change in sales price. Okay, so what will happen in the profit if there is a change in price? If there is a change in number of units to be sold? Or di kaya yung cost structure, so yung variable cost, saka yung fixed cost, and even, so pag the company is maraming siyang products, so is there a need or how much the product mix? So, ano yung product mix structure ng company? So, that is for CVP analysis. So, elements of CVP analysis, so, kumbaga, again and again, there is a need to determine the sales, the selling price, and the units or volume. And second one is here to determine the total fixed cost necessary for or within the normal capacity of the company. Then, the variable cost per unit. And the sales mix, this is intended for multiple products. So, these are the elements of CVP analysis. Or data needed, they are the data needed in CVP or cost volume profit analysis. And then, the contribution margin income statement. So, this is actually katong inyuhang variable costing na income statement. Which starts with the sales, the units multiplied by selling price, less the variable costs, which is the units multiplied by the variable cost per unit. And so, di ba the difference of sales and saka yung variable cost is yung contribution margin. So, contribution margin, yun nga, the amount that can be allocated to fixed cost. Okay? So, contributed to fixed cost. So, in this case, less the fixed cost. So, dari, naapagin sa excess. Okay, so, that is income before tax or the operating profit. So, this is the basic structure of the contribution margin income statement or the variable costing income statement. Assumptions of CBP, the first one is all costs are classified as either variable and fixed cost. Kasi nga, this is also part of variable costing. So there's a need to determine muna how much is yung variable tsaka how much yung fixed cost of a particular product. Cost and the revenue relationships are predictable and linear within the relevant range of activity and a specified period of time. So, syempre, if it is within the relevant range of activity, if the variable cost, with regards to variable cost, di ba, nag-vary much na depende sa number of units. So, if the level of activity increases, syempre, the variable costs will also increase. But, the fixed cost will always, no, be at fixed within the normal range or normal capacity. Kasi pag may excess capacity na siya, there is a need to increase fixed cost. And total variable cost change directly with cost drivers, yung sabi ko kanina. But variable cost per unit, okay, are constant over the relevant range. So, again and again, no, the total variable costs may change, may vary, depending on the activity. Okay, the level of activity. But, in per unit basis, the variable cost per unit are constant. Alright, over the relevant range. Total fixed cost naman, yung totality ng fixed cost is constant over a relevant range. But, yung fixed cost per unit may vary inversely. Okay, with the cost driver or volume or within the capacity. So, baliktad siya when it comes to variable cost. Kasi yung variable cost, totality, mag-change siya depende sa level of activity. But in cost or per unit basis, the variable cost per unit are constant. Okay, it's constant. And the fixed cost naman in totality, fixed siya. Okay, constant siya within the relevant range. But cost per unit may vary inversely with the cost driver or volume. Next one is selling prices per unit. The market conditions remains unchanged. Kasi nga, this will be used in computation of how much is the break-even point in terms of units and in terms of pesos. And then, production equals sales. So, there is no change in inventory. So, parang walang ending inventory as much as possible. And if the company sells multiple products, there is a need to compute for sales mix and that sales mix is constant. Alright? The technology as well as productive efficiency is constant. So, yung fixed costs, kung pa pwede yun nga, constant siya within the relevant range of activity. And the time value of money is ignored. So, in this case, wala pong discounting. Okay? So, wala pong discounting dito. So, you do have here the next one. Okay? So, the next one is the CBP graph. So, as you can see, you do have here yung linear. Okay? Linear relationship between the fixed cost here, the units, and the pesos. Okay? So, you do have here the line. And, so, nasa ibabaw, this is the sa gitna, that is the break-even point. So, in which the total, okay, income is equal to total expenses. So, break-even siya. So, in this case, the profit is zero. So, as the break-even point, so, yun nga, it may be nasa sa mga 390-something, no? So, in this case class, if mo increase siya, be above the break-even point, it means profit. So, in this case, you have the profit area. And if it is below the break-even point, so it means the company incur losses. Okay? So, this is the simple CBP graph illustration. Factors affecting profit, syempre, the selling price of the product. Okay? So, how much the selling price also will affect the profit, same with the number of units sold, the one in terms of quantity, yun nga. The unit variable cost, the fixed cost, and the mix or combination of products sold, so yung sales mix. All these factors should be considered in profit planning. Okay? So, cost volume profit analysis shows the relationship between these variables which form the basis for profit planning. So, how much is the break-even point? So, pilang ilang target para makabawi sa ilahang capital. Okay, sa ilahang capital, it may be, yun nga, if gusto ka magka-income, dapat more than the break-even point. Okay, so meron silang target, meron silang basis kung bakit planning. And the break-even analysis, so you do have here the first one, is yung single product break-even. So pag single product break-even formula, so you do have here, so if yung single product niya, isa lang siya mga product, and we are to compete for that one, the break-even in units and break-even in pesos. So break-even in units, the competition here, is the total fixed cost divided by contribution margin per unit, while break-even in pesos naman, the total fixed cost divided by contribution margin ratio. So another competition, or yung formula pala, it may be your to compete for contribution margins. Yeah, kabala naman tani no, that the contribution margin is equal to sales minus variable cost. And contribution margin per unit, that is sales price per unit, okay, so yung sales price, selling price, minus the variable cost per unit. And the contribution margin ratio, it is just that contribution margin divided by sales. How much is your contribution margin in terms of sales? So let's have example. So you do have here, consider the following data. So meron siyang sales for 10, the variable cost. So okay kayo no, kaya naka-separate na variable cost. And even na na siya contribution margin. And then fixed cost of 30, then profit 40. So let's compute for the break-even point in terms of units. So ano pala yung formula? So this one. So BP, break-even point in units, you do have fixed cost is equal to contribution margin per unit is equal to fixed cost na 330. So asagi ka ng 30, dala ka niya fixed cost. Then divided by 4, 4 is the contribution margin per unit. Okay. Bakit unit? Kasi nga the question here is in units. So break-even point in units. So you do have here the competition for yun niya, break-even contribution margin per unit. So contribution margin per unit is equal to selling price minus variable cost per unit. So 10 minus 6 is equal to 4. So 4 yung contribution margin per unit. Pasagi ka ng 10, dala to selling price given. 6 naman sa variable costs given. So the answer is 7,500. So kumbaga, if the company gusto niya na zero profit, na zero nga. So kumbaga, at break even, hindi kaya yun nga, zero ang profit is 7,500 units siya. So at break even, the units needed is 7,500. Then, in terms of pesos naman, so it's parang same lang ang formula, change mo lang yung nasa baba, 2CM ratio, contribution margin ratio. So in this case, 30,000 pa rin, which is the fixed costs, and then 40% as computed sa baba. So, contribution margin ratio is equal to contribution margin divided by sales. So, 40,000 divided by 100,000, 40% ang iyahang contribution margin ratio. So, asagi ka na 40, 40 is the contribution margin, and 100 is the sales. So, 100. So, in this case, you do have here the answer for break-even point in pesos, 75,000. So, in order to break even, yun nga, kailangan niya na 75,000 na sales. Okay? So, let's have a proving Douglas. Proving, no? If tama ba yun siya, no? Profit ba yun is zero or break even at point of 7,500 units or 75,000 sales. So, let's try. Okay? Kung zero ba yun siya, ang yahang profit if ang units na babalik niya 7,500 or 75,000 in pesos. So, you do have the first one, syempre the sales. And then the variable cost, syempre mag-vary siya, depende sa level of activity. So, in this case, the level of activity is 7,500 units multiplied by 6. So, na siya 45,000 of variable cost per unit. Therefore, the contribution margin here is 30,000. So, 75,000 minus 45, so, nasa contribution margin na 30,000. And then, the fixed cost here is given. So, always fixed man siya, diba, in totality, in whatever level of activity, constant po yung fixed cost. So, you do have 30,000 na fixed cost. So, therefore, the profit here is zero. So, in order to break even, si company dapat mahalinan siya o 7,500. Kung gusto niya magka-income, siyempre dapat lapas sa 7,500 ang iyahang halin. Okay. So, you do have here, single. Okay. Talking before, single product for break-even analysis. Next year is the multiple product break-even. So, assuming hindi lang isang product yung binibenta ng company. Okay. So, if that's the case, last, i-compute mo isa-isa yung contribution margin per unit ni product A, product B, at saka product C. So, after computing the contribution margin per unit, multiply mo siya sa sales mix ratio. So, how much is product A of the total products, product B of the total products, product C of the total products, and weighted average contribution margin for product A, excuse me, product B, product C, add mo lang lahat. So that is the weighted average contribution margin. And then, sales or mixes to break even. So, in this case, class, same lang sila ng competition kanina. So, still, total fixed cost divided by contribution margin per unit if the basis is per unit. So, if it is in pesos naman, change the contribution margin into contribution margin ratio as denominator. Pero in this case, just meron siyang weighted average. So, yung total yung kanina. Total as computed yung number 1, that is the weighted average contribution margin per unit. That individual break-even point in units, in this case, isa-isahon na nimo siya kung pila GDI ang per unit for product A to break-even, B and C. So, BEP in units in all products multiplied by sales mix ratio. So, this was the computed kanina yung BEP in units on all products. Then, the sales mix ratio multiply. So, you do have BEP in units multiplied by sales price. So, this is the BEP in peso. So, to better understand this one, so let's have the sample problem. Okay. So, sample problem here. A company sells products A, B, and C. Data about the three products are as follows. So, products A, B, and C. The selling price, 100, 120, 50. Variable cost per unit, 60, 90, 40. Contribution margin, 40, 30, 10. And you do have sales in units. So, this is 1,000, 2,000, 3, 5,000. So, a total of 8,000. And the total fixed cost is 101, 680. So, itong sales in units, ito yung gagawin nyo, okay, para ma-compute nyo sales mix later. The first one is computation of weighted average contribution margin. So, the first one is in terms of units. So, in this case, you do have here, si product A, so, masagikan na kaning contribution margin per unit. So, given na sa class, yung nasa ibabaw, 40, 30, at saka 20. Then, sales mix naman, this one, is based on nasa baba. Okay? So, ito nasa baba, di ba, asan yung sagikan? Actually, dri na sagikan. Okay? So, 1,000 divided by 8. Okay? So, that is 12.5%. Then, 2,000 divided by 8,000, so 25% for B. Kay C naman, 5,000 divided by 8,000, so 62.5% kay product C. And then, after computing for this one, the next one is computation of weighted average contribution margin. Then, you do have here the weighted average contribution margin. So, sales in units, variable costs in unit, variable cost total. Then, this is sales pala in total, the contribution margin total. So, in this case, you do have here to compute for WAC, weighted average contribution margin ratio, the total contribution margin divided by total sales. So, 150 yung total contribution margin for A, B, and C divided by 519 na total sales for A, B, and C. So, nasa 25.42%. Okay. So, para asan dito itong di-compute ganina sa number 1? So, kato siya para pag-compute later on upon sa number 2, company's break-even point. So, if it is based on units, so what you're going to do, fixed cost lang siya. So, fixed cost na 101,680 divided by 18.75 as computed kanina for weighted average contribution margin per unit. So, nasa total units to break even, 5,423 units. So, in terms of pesos naman, okay, so fixed cost na 101,680 divided by 25.42%, so, nasa 400,000 okay, pesos to break even. So, again, break even in units, 5,423. For break even in pesos, so 400,000. And then, individual naman na break even point in units, so madali lang, it's break cost. So, break even point in units, so you do have all products kay A, B, and C. O, kasi diba, this is all products. And imuhang i-multiply sa sales mix ratio para makumpit ang individual. So, for BEP in units, for product ay nasa 678. Then, for B naman, 1,356. Kay C naman, 3,389. So, a total of 5,423. Then, multiply by the sales price, so na ay BEP in pesos sa A, product A, na 67,800. B naman, 162,720. C naman, 169,450. So, a total of BEP in pesos na 399,700. 399,970. Sorry po. Then, let's have the next one. If meron kang target profit. Okay, required sales with target or desired profit. So, para na siyang profit planning. So, if there is a required sales or desired profit, if for a single product, so sa the numerator, okay, so itong numerator, mag-nalang siya additional, which is yung target profit. So, what do you mean by target profit pala? So, if the company wanted to have, may kanina ako ang gusto nga profit, 100,000, pila kaya ako ang dapat nga ibaligya? So, pwede magamit kanina mga formula. So, same lang ang pag-compute ng BEP, ang nadugang ng saya, ha, is ang numerator, kanina mga naka-red. Okay? Ang DP is the desired profit. So, plus na nung sa total fixed cost, so, you do have contribution margin per unit. And same with this one, sa kabila. So, plus na nimo ang desired profit. Then, ito nasa baba naman, this is actually after tax. Okay. So, to earn desired amount after tax, so, i-work back siya. So, NP, net profit, divided by 1 minus TR, which is the tax rate. Okay. Para makompute niyo yung before tax niya nga income. Before tax nga income plus the total fixed cost divided by contribution margin per unit. And then sa RSP naman, in terms of pesos, same pa rin. Total fixed cost plus yung before tax nga income, okay, divided by contribution margin ratio. The same as well with the multiple products. And then, like if for example, if Mackie Incorporated sells a single product for 10, variable costs are 4 per unit, and fixed cost total 120,000 at the volume level of 10,000 units. So the management would like to earn a target profit before tax of 240. So the first one is required sales in units. So pila di ay dapat niya nga mahalin in terms of units, okay, para maka-income siya. Okay, hilo na nga 240,000. So, ang sayang buhaton? So, RS is equals to TFC, total fixed cost plus a desired profit divided by contribution margin per unit. So, why contribution margin per unit? Since the question is in units. Substitute the formula, 120,000 na fixed cost plus 240 na target profit and then divided by the contribution margin per unit na 10, okay, the sales price minus 4 na per unit variable cost. And then 360 divided by 6, so dapat makahalin siya og 60,000 units, okay, para magka-income siya og 240,000. So record sales in pesos naman. So same lang ang formula, but change the denominator to contribution margin ratio. So, in this case, to compute for contribution margin ratio, okay, so ano yung gagawin? Yung 6, which is the contribution margin, divided by 10 nga sales price. So, nasa 60%. So, 360 divided by 60%, so, kailangan niya, okay, mahalin o 600,000 para maka-earn siya ng 240 na profit or net income. And then, the next one is yung margin of safety. Sarat-sada na ni class, no? So, margin of safety naman, this indicates the amount or levels of sales by which actual or planned sales may be reduced without incurring a loss. So, pila yung allowance bago sa magka-loss. So, margin of safety. Again, margin of safety, it is the amount of peso sales or number of units by which the actual or budgeted sales may be decreased without resulting into a loss. So, parang pila gida ang iyang allowance bago sa magka-loss. It may be in terms of peso or in terms of units. So, the formula for this one, it may be the margin of safety in pesos, which is sales in pesos minus break-even point in pesos. And this one in units naman, minus lang mo ang sales in units minus the break-even point in units or di kaya MS, so margin of safety is equals to margin of safety okay, in pesos divided by selling price. Or di kaya in terms of rate naman, in terms of ratio, so you do have margin of safety in pesos divided by sales for total sales in pesos. Or margin of safety ratio is equals to margin of safety in units divided by sales per unit. Okay. And then let's have a sample problem here. So as you can see, if a company presents sales in 100,000 units, okay, present sales is 100,000 units or 500,000 because of the selling price na 5 and the break-even point is 60,000 units or 300,000, so, to compete for margin of safety in pesos, so, ang difference lang siya, dali lang kayo sa class, kaya margin of safety in pesos, difference lang sa sales na 500,000 minus 300,000 na break-even point. Or di kaya, you do have your margin of safety na 200. So, nasa yung allowance na 200, okay, bago siya magka-loss. Diba, ang requirement niya nga break-even is 300. The based on actual, na pa si 200 yung allowance bago sa magka-loss. So, the next one here in terms of units. So, as you can see, the formula is just margin of safety in units is equal to sales in units minus break-even point in units. So, sales in units is 100,000 minus 60,000 na break-even point in units. So, nasa 40,000 units nga allowance. Okay, so in terms of ratio naman, okay, so, or maybe you do have your pala, other way to compute for this one, si 200 kanina, na margin of safety in peso divided by 5 na selling price, na siya 40,000 units needed, okay, or di kaya allowance niya bago siya magka-loss, na pa siya sobra, kasi 60,000 ang break-even, di ba, so it means to say 60,000 na siya break-even or zero ang profit, and then, based on actual, na pa siya sobra ang 40,000. So, nasa yung margin of safety na in terms of units na 40,000. In terms of ratio naman, so you do have here, just divide lang 200,000 na margin of safety in pesos divided by 500,000 na sales price. So, nasa yung 40%. And then, or it may be computed using the units. So, margin of safety in units divided by 100,000 na sales in units. So, nasa yung 40%. Okay. And then, the company can reduce its present sales of 50,000 by 200,000. Kasi yung 200,000 yung allowance niya bago niya magalos. Or by 40,000 units or 40,000 without incurring a loss. So, maximum na niya. Kung gusto mo niya i-reduce ang present sales, dapat 200 lang ang iyahang. 200,000 lang dapat ang ma-decrease na maximum para dili siya magka- loss. Or di kaya 40 units na decrease or 40%. Okay, so that is for margin of safety ratio. And the last one here is the operating leverage. So the operating leverage measures the effect that percentage of change in sales revenue has on pre-tax profit. So now if there is a change in revenue, how much it is in terms of profit? So income before tax. It is computed as follows. So, the degree of operating leverage is equal to contribution margin divided by income before tax. Okay. Siguro beer following in the company's operation result from its present sales of 10,000 units. So to compete for degree of operating leverage, this just DOL is equal to contribution margin divided by income before tax. So na siya 2.5 times alright, change in sales alright, or income if merong change sa sales. So 2.5 times change sa income if merong change sa sales. So, thank you very much for listening po, no? So, if you do have questions, feel free to ask sa group chat po natin or you can personally message me po. So, that's it for the cost volume profit analysis discussion. So, thank you very much for your patience. Goodbye and God bless.